In the previous video, we covered connecting the programming board for SigmaStudio programming, saving, loading demo programs, and restoring factory settings. In this video, we will explain the correspondence between demo program and hardware, as well as how to modify the cutoff frequency of filter. We won't demonstrate the basic operations and how to connect the programming board here. If you need it, please refer to the first video. Without further ado, let's get started. First, open the SigmaStudio software and click on File, then Open to open the demo program. If the bottom right corner of the page shows Design Mode, click on Link Compile Connect to compile the program once, then click on Link Compile Download. If it shows Active, Downloaded in the bottom right corner, you can start online debugging. Let's look at the correspondence between the demo program and the ADAU1701 DSP preamp. As we all know, this ADAU1701 DSP preamp provides two inputs and four outputs. The 0 and 1 of the input module correspond to two analog inputs. The DAC 0, 1, 2, and 3 here correspond to four analog outputs. For ease of use, we have added frequency division modules in between the input and output. Therefore, this DSP preamp comes with a digital crossover. DAC 0 and DAC 1 correspond to the base output channel, while DAC 2 and DAC 3 correspond to the mid-range output channel. We have also marked the DAC corresponding to the output channel on the silk screen. You can see that a mute module is added before each DAC in the program. We can use the mute function to find the corresponding hardware channel. Let's give it a try.
The last that ever she saw him, carried away by a moonlight shadow, he passed on worried and warning, carried away by a moonlight shadow, lost in a riddle that Saturday night, far away on the other side, he was caught in the middle of a desperate fight, and she couldn't find how to push through. Trees that whisper in the evening, carried away by a moonlight of sorrow and grieving, carried away by a moonlight shadow. All she saw was a silhouette.
After understanding the input and output, let's take a look at the functions in between and their correspondence with the hardware. These modules are for muting and correspond to the mute switch on the front panel of the front-end module. After that, we divide the signal. Let's start with the base output channel. These modules are used as high-pass filters for the base channel and correspond to pot 3 on the front panel. You can see that the default adjustment range for the cutoff frequency is 10 Hz to 310 Hz. This adjustment range can be customized based on your preferences and speaker specifications. These modules are low-pass filters for the base channel and correspond to MP8/ADC3 pot 2 on the front panel. The default adjustment range for the cutoff frequency is 210 Hz to 3 kHz. Similarly, you can make adjustments according to your preferences. Next is the phase, which corresponds to the phase switch SW2 on the front panel. Now let's look at the mid-range output channel. First, we have a high-pass filter for the mid-range channel, which corresponds to pot 1 on the front panel. The default adjustment range for the cutoff frequency is 3 kHz to 20 kHz, and you can make adjustments according to your preferences. These three modules adjust the relative gain of the mid-range and base output channels and correspond to pot 5 on the rear panel. The following modules are for gain compensation. It's not recommended to adjust this part. If you have made changes to the program and want to run it offline, you need to write the modified program to the DSP. Click on Hardware Configuration to enter the Hardware Configuration page. Select ADAU1701, then right-click and choose Write Latest Compilation to E2 PROM. A dialog box will appear. Simply click OK. At this point, the program has been downloaded to the ADAU1701 DSP preamp. If you found this video helpful, please kindly consider liking, sharing, or leaving a comment. Thank you for your support and valuable feedback.